Again, the process capability index is to measure the how well process is capable of producing relative to the design specifications. So we want to know whether CPK is greater than 1 or less than 1 or closer to 2 or less than 1. So that will indicate how capable of the process in terms of our measured process. So look at the problem here. This is about quality assurance manager is assessing the capability of their process that put pressurized grease in a water can. And as you see, the design specification is set 60 pound per square pi of pressure. So upper specification is the 65 pi. And lower specification limit is the 55 pi. And then we take the sample and found the average sample mean is 61 pi with a standard deviation of 2 pi. So with this information, we are able to find out capability index, CPK. So what is the capability of process? It's asking the CPK. And what is the probability of producing a defect using the G-scores? Okay, first one, you need to interpret the data from the problem. So find out lower specification limit, upper specification limit, and here the sample mean, x double bar, and the standard deviation, sigma. So we found those information and calculate CPA based on the your formula. So minimum of sample mean minus lower specification limit divided by 3 sigma or upper specification limit minus sample mean divided by 3 sigma. So 61 minus 55 divided by 3 times 2 or 65 minus sample mean 61 divided by 3 times 2. That two value comes out, you take the minimum value, which is 0.6060667, which is less than 1. So we roughly guess that this process capability is not so good, need to be improved. But we don't know how much, what is the percentage of or probability of producing a defect. So using the G-score, first of all, you need to look at the probability of a can with less than 55 pi, which is a lower specification limit, and the probability of can with more than 65 pi. So, left tail and the white tail. So left tail and white tail, we combine these. This is the probability of being defect, producing a defect. There are two ways you can, calculate this process. One is you can use the, this cumulative standard normal distribution. But this is easily can be calculated using the Microsoft Excel function, which is a norm S distribution, DSIT. So I recommend using this Excel function instead of going through this cumulative standard normal distribution. But let's go back to the question. The lower specification limit for G-score is negative 3 based on the formula. The 55 minus 61 divided by 2, so negative 3, which means you can find the negative 3 here. So that actually the gray area here, which is a probability 0.00135. Okay? But you can simply, and then probability of a can with more than 65 pi, which is upper side in white tail. Based on the formula, G-score is 2. So around here, but that, this graph shows the 0.977, which is this area, but we want to know this ungraded area, because greater than, this area, so it's 1 minus the graded area. Usually in the upper, in the white tail, we have to use the 1 minus the probability. And left tail, we just use the probability. I'm sorry. So go back. So probability is here 0.0013, and for this is the less than probability of less with less than 55 pi plus, and then more than 65 pi is the 0.0225. So when you combine these, we find the 0.024, which is approximately 2.4%. That's the probability of producing a defect. So 2.4% is the defect rate. If you use the Excel function, so probability with less than 55 pi is the left tail, you can find normal standard distribution function and use the negative 3. The probability is exactly the same using the cumulative standard normal distribution, right? And probability with more than 65 pi, which is a white tail, we have to use the 1 minus norm standard distribution, which is positive 2. Exactly the same as this, right? So when you combine these two, that's the probability of 2.4 defective rate. That's the probability. Okay? Let's have another problem. So C-SPEC incorporation is attempting to determine whether existing machine is capable of milling an engine part that has key specification of 4 plus minus 0.003 inches. So you know the design specification limit, upper limit, lower limit is given here. So 4 minus 0.003 is the lower specification limit. 4 plus 0.003 is the upper specification limit. And then we get a sample, so we found that sample mean is the 4.001 inch, standard deviation is 0.002 inch. So with that, we can find the CPK equals UTR is simply is the same as USL, is the upper tolerance limit or specification limit is the same. So upper limit is the 4.003, minus sample mean is the 4.001 divided by 3 times standard deviation is 0.002 comma, and then sample mean 4.0021 minus lower tolerance or specification limit is the 4 minus 0.003, so 3.997 divided by 3 times 0.002, then these two numbers come out. So we take the minimum, which is 0.003, which is far less than 1 capability index. So we can conclude that this machine is not capable of producing the part at the desired quality level. Based on the Six Sigma theory, we simply can conclude that this is not a capable process. Okay, in the next video clip, I will explain control chart. Thank you.